In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still, when striving cease. My comforter, my all and all, here in the love of Christ I stand. Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe. This gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on the cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid. Here in the death of Christ I live. Bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands at victory, since Christ has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. In life, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. And no power of hell, no scheme of man, can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand. And no power of hell, no scheme of man, can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand.
It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 in the afternoon, for the sun stopped shining, and the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Jesus called out with a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." When he had said this, he breathed his last. The centurion, seeing what had happened, praised God and said, "Surely this was a righteous man." When all the people who had gathered to witness this sight saw what took place, they beat their breasts and went away. But all those who knew him, including the women who had followed him from Galilee, stood at a distance watching these things.
Seventh statement, a word of trust. Finally, moments before Jesus ended his mortal ministry on earth, he cried, "Father, into thy hands I commend my spirit." Perhaps the key word in this seventh and final statement is "I," which indicating that Jesus willingly gave up his life. Note also Jesus intimately addresses God as Father. In the Gospel of Luke, Christ's first recorded words at a young age of just 12 years are when he asks Mary and Joseph, "Did you not know that I must be about my Father's business?" And now Mary's witness provides the heart-wrenching answer. He had finished the work his Father sent him to do. Christ gave himself completely to God. Do we do the same? Are we willing to allow our will to be completely swallowed up in the will of the Father?
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still, when striving cease. Comforter, my all and all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe. This gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on the cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid. Here in the death of Christ I live. Bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands in victory, since Christ has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. In life, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in till he returns or calls me home. Here in the power of Christ, I'll stand.